Earthworms are among the most important soil animals, with strong effects on soil structure and chemical properties. These effects can be good or bad depending on the soil the earthworms inhabit. In soils managed by humans, earthworms are usually good. Earthworm tunneling through the compacted soil of a farm field allows water to flow to where plant roots can access it. Yet plants need nutrients as well as water, and redworms are experts at breaking down food, yard, and farm wastes into nutrient-rich compost for growing new crops. However, in natural soils that historically have not had native earthworms, they can drastically change the soil and the natural community it supports. In forests of the northern United States, invasive earthworms introduced by dumping fishing bait and moving soil thin out the soil's covering of leaf litter, translocating the organic matter deeper into the soil. This disrupts native plant communities and paves the way for invasive species to take over, turning a diverse and vibrant forest floor into a weedy monoculture, permanently altering the region's ecology. Yet even in our own cities and backyards, earthworms can sometimes cause mischief. As this crazy snake worm feeds on the dead stems of a residential lawn, it removes the cover and reveals bare soil beneath, making the lawn look thin and barren. On golf courses, small mounds of fecal material that earthworms deposit on the ground surface can disrupt the roll of an otherwise well-placed putt. These are just some examples of how earthworms can affect the soils they inhabit. Despite their benefits in some environments, the powerful changes they can induce mean they should not be carelessly introduced into new soils. With great power comes great responsibility, and since earthworms aren't very smart, it's up to us to make sure they stay in places where they can use their powers for good.